I heard about this kid that plays basketball. All I knew was that the consensus was he was scared to come to a workout. And ideally, if I was him, I might be scared too. Everyone was telling him how hard these workouts were, and that, you know, ideally, he might not like it. So, you know, his depiction of the story is, you know, the kids are telling him to come work out. And that's true. Gabe and various kids, Rakim, they come and they tell me, you need to get this. Even the coach at the time, well, coach still, Coach Lonergan, say, hey, you need to come, you need to work with that kid. Dang. I said, well, I heard he thinks he knows everything. And I remember the day he came in to the coach's office. And what he was asking Coach Lonergan was, can he play in the JV game? He's like, no, you can't play in the JV game. Because he had officially become the varsity kicker. And I didn't know the kid like that, but I knew that he was trying to do his best to talk Coach Lonergan out of forcing him to come to this workout or do anything he could so he didn't have to come outside and do what varsity was about to do. So day one, you know, was me seeing all of his deficiencies, his problems, his potentials. And I remember seeing him do one move, and he says it in his interview, and he's said it many times now. And I told him, I said, dude, if you don't get control of you know, this and that, then you're going to have some knee and some lower back injuries, and if not injuries, definitely some problems. So I remember him looking up as he was doing some seated squats on the stairs outside at the stadium and saying, you know, no one's ever told me that before. And I said, well, I'm only telling you the truth. It's just a matter of time, my friend. So, at any hoop, the next day he came down and he was in weights class, and I was there, and he asked me for some other stuff, and we did a few more workouts. And he comes and tells me he actually went to the chiropractor the day after, and they were assessing, I guess, his flaws, his back was bothering him or something, and they told him basically the same thing. They said, you know, your back and knee problems are coming from your weak hips, unfortunately. You know, cracking it and clanking it every so many weeks isn't going to fix it. The boy needs to be able to play sports. So you have to strengthen it properly, and most importantly, protect him while he's strengthening it. So, you know, he was affirmed by a doctor who I've never met, don't know the name of, in less than 24 hours, that I was right. So I believe it was either me that went to him or him that went to me and asked for a little bit more assistance as far as training is concerned. And, you know, we kept getting after it, and he started learning a little bit more, doing a little bit more. And I remember him telling me that I told my mom and dad about you last night. That's very common. You know, you go through anything that Tfit puts together, and you can go home and tell somebody about it. you want somebody to hear about what just happened. So shortly after, you know, spoke with mom, met dad, and we all came to an agreement and got an understanding of who I was, what I was trying to do, what I could do. And, you know, basically was at it ever since. And in the process of making him Tfit, one thing I love about Tfit is another thing I don't know if he remembers, but I took him and a couple kids with me down to the coach's experience. We had the opportunity to speak at Coaches Versus Cancer to some kids and those that are less fortunate. I remember one of the kids giving him a shirt, and he says, no, I don't, what he said, I haven't done enough yet or something like that. Because the clothes, you know, they send the message. If you have Tfit or if you are Tfit, people, they know you're not average. Now, the other part about the clothes that most people don't understand is you know, the ones that have the chosen shirts, the Danans of the world, the Rocks of the world, the Gabes of the world, the Andres of the world, the Hobbs, and a few others. Those kids can save your life. They can change your current state, how you feel about, you know, what you're doing exercise-wise, fix your pains, get rid of it. One thing I've learned about Danan is that he cares. What I was able to do was take his care to the next level. I've taken him to schools, and many schools, to be a part of many programs, to be an example. I don't take him because of his name or what the kids think he is. I take him because I know he's going to do the right thing. No matter what, I know that he's going to set the example. I know he's not going to keep his mouth shut about, you know, mistakes. I know that regardless of where we go, he's going to hold people, kids, other athletes, accountable for their mistakes. And I know that he's going to lead by example. So I take him like I would take Andre, like I would take Gabe, like I'd take, you know, Boyer and a few others with me places to send a message. These kids want to be perfect. These kids want to be the best. These kids want to be better than others. So, you know, my story is very simple with Danan. He was a little concerned at first when we first started about what was about to happen. But once he understood what it was that I was going to do for him, he, like others who don't plan on finishing just in college, don't plan on being an average high school athlete, meaning let me just play so I, you know, can hang out with my friends. They become addicted. Addicted to 100. They are addicted to perfection. They're addicted to being aware and understanding what they're doing, what they're not doing, how to make things better, how to jump higher. I met this kid at the bottom of the net. If I would have taken a video, which I should have done, of him jumping the first day, oh my God, it was atrocious. I'm like, seriously? And I remember his goofy friend, D-Lo, saying, now, if you can get Danan to dunk, and Fool said, I know your program works there. So we got him to dunk. But now, you know, even D-Lo gets a little bit higher and has a little bit better understanding of what's going on when he's doing various things. But they help each other out. That's the other beauty about this system. It's people helping people. It's kids helping kids. It's kids correcting kids. It's kids correcting adults. It's kids protecting themselves and protecting their teammates, friends, and various other people. So I've had a blast with Danan, and, you know, he and I and a few others are going to have a blast, hopefully impacting the rest of the world. You know, we've lost one, but every time we lose one, we've gained another one that wants to be the best that he can be. I'm troubled and was troubled when Dre died, and some of the things that Danan sent me about, you know, the loss, because I was key. They were key. He hit the nail on the head. And then I think he went, when I said something about quitting Tfit or just stopping because I didn't sign up for this when we all lost Dre, you know, he went and told his mama. and I got a long text from his mama, you know, like, boy, you crazy. You know, you can't quit on these kids. So, you know, I love each and every kid that I come in contact with, especially the ones that I consider my kids, the one that spend hours and days and weeks at a time with me. I honestly thought by now Danan would be on to bigger and better things, working with various trainers, because I don't sell my training. I'm not interested in training. I'm interested only in changing. But, you know, he keeps coming back. And, you know, I've thanked him now, and I'm thanking him again for committing to being one of the best athletes he can be, and even more importantly, hopefully, even when I'm not around, a good example. But I know that when we are working out and exercising, he does a great job of representing what I would want any kid athlete to represent. So, again, been a blast. Love the kid to death. Every time that we put up a Tfit Tuesday, I'll do my own little, hey, this is how he got inducted. This is how he was chosen. Technically, most of them make the choice, and then I come in and push a few things and basically put my foot on their throat, and then they make a decision at that moment after that that the real Tfit, which very few of you know about, if they want to do this, especially on a regular. This fool Juwan texting me talking about he ran into Nigel. So to that point, Danon made the right choice, and I only hope that I'm giving and give him the results that he seeks. But I know for a fact I've ran into 5 or 6 people, and one in particular regularly that tells me about what Danon's done for him. And that's my mission. My mission is to educate one so he can educate another and they can save another life every day and everywhere they work. The kids, as he said in his video, they can't save everybody until they've been given the okay. But the people that they hold close and dear to their heart, be it mother, father, sister, brother, they know to do the right thing to protect your family. So, as they will say,
done saying, I'm done playing. Last time is on the outro. Stuck in the house, need to get out more. I've been stacking up like I'm fundraising. Most people in my position get complacent. Wanna come places with star girls and they end up on them front pages. I'm quiet without just